It's that time.
It's game time, baby.
That time. Time to kick off Sports Extra. Brought to you by Southside Lumber, Southern Illinois Orthopedic Center, and Subway. Now, News 3's Sports Extra.
Sports Extra.
Greetings and welcome to the regular season finale of Sports Extra. Area teams fell into three categories tonight. Those that must win to make the playoffs, those looking to improve playoff seeding, or those simply trying to finish up on a positive note. We start with a high-stakes rivalry game. In Marion, the 7-1 Wildcats look to improve their playoff positioning. While it was win and get in for the 4-4 Heron Tigers early on, Heron's defense up to the challenge. David Mallow is going to sack Dalton Robertson on fourth down. Tigers would go for it on fourth down, and they're in a little trickery. Razzle-dazzle, Marshall Anderson going to pick up big yardage for the first down. That set up a touchdown. Heron up 6-0. But here comes Marion's defense. Mallow on the run, but he gets stripped. And there is Drew Bradford on the return. And trust me, Drew's on the return. Some few dozen coaches in the way there. But anyway, Marion goes on to score here on the touchdown run from Aaron McFadden. Extra point is good. 7-6 Wildcats. Then it's Shaquille Ivey busting loose for 22 yards. And the Wildcats were in business again. Ivey dragging tacklers. Moments later, it's Ivey going to punch it in from a yard out, and it was 13-6 Tigers, or 13-6 Wildcats. End of the half, Heron trying to run out the clock on fourth down, try to fake punt. Marion's Nick Hudson up to the task. That would set up this Colton King's 44-yard field goal, and the Wildcats led 16-6 at the break, and they go on to win it 30-14. Your final. Another area 4-4 team is Hamilton County. The Foxes faced Fairfield tonight in a win or stay home finale. First quarter, Fairfield's Andrew Atterbury fumbles the ball on the Foxes 2, recovered by Hamilton County's Brandon Webb. But no gain in two downs. The Mules able to tackle Lucas Johnson in the end zone for the safety. Later in the first, it's Matt Brown up the gut for 2-yard touchdown, and the Mules had the lead. Then it's teammate Dylan Sarles with the catch for the two-point conversion. 10-0 Fairfield. But here come the Foxes near the end of the half. Josh Hall pushes his way in from 5 yards out. Then Logan Karcher will come through with the two-point conversion. 10-8 Fairfield at the half. And the Mules hang on to win it. Your final, 16-14. More from the Black Diamond in a bit. At 4-4, the Nashville Hornets also faced a must-win situation tonight. At home against Columbia, senior night for the Hornets. You know they didn't want to end their careers at home with a loss. Third play from scrimmage, it's Gannon Mammel busting through the middle and into the open field. 56 yards for the score. The Hornets strike first, but the Eagles would answer. On fourth and one, Columbia just will get it over the goal line. We were tied at 7. Now, second quarter action. Columbia trying to keep the momentum rolling here. The touchdown pass from 11 yards out, and the Eagles had a 14-7 lead. But this night would belong to Mammel. Number 7 takes it around in, and he is gone. His second score of the day, but he was not done. Hornets' first drive of the second half, and well, guess who? It's Mammel taking the handoff on fourth and goal, and he gets in, and Nashville looks to be good on playoff points. Your final, they win it tonight 35-21. Even at 5-3, it was likely a must-win for AJ tonight against Benton. The Wildcats probably wouldn't have enough playoff points to get in at 5-4, so they got down to business early. Wildcats already up 9-0 in the first. Benton's Tyler Leffler drops back and is picked off by Gabe Peekard. He takes it all the way down to the Rangers, too. Very next play, Peekard finishes what he started, goes untouched for the score. He also took the two-point conversion in, making it 17-0 at that point. Then, just for good measure, it's Peekard again. This time he takes the pass from Jared Woodward up the sideline, 72 yards to the house, and that's all AJ would need. They roll over Benton, 23-0, your final. Next stop, Carbondale. The Terriers welcoming Harrisburg. Both teams here looking to improve their playoff positioning. Here's Carbondale's Kendall Edwards with the 10-yard run. Then he would take it into the end zone from 3 yards out. Terriers up 7-0. Second quarter now, Bulldogs. Dawson Monfort will pick off Max Krause. Harrisburg has great field position. Bulldogs take advantage. Reed Roper to Isaac Beam. And we were tied up at 7. Second half now. It's Monfort on the ground. He runs over a Carbondale player at the goal line for the score. 13-7 Bulldogs. Fourth quarter now. Kraus picked off again, his third of the game. That would set up Roper to Beam on the option for the score. Harrisburg goes on to win it 21-7. Johnson City is another team sitting with five wins. Number six would have to come at home against Black Diamond champion Cesar Valier Waltonville Woodlawn. A Red Devils team trying to wrap up a perfect regular season. First quarter, Brock Wheatley, 54 yards for the score. Red Devils up 6-0. Later in the second, Indians punter Dustin Solomon with a nice punt. It goes off Wheatley's face mask. Johnson City is there to capitalize. Indians fans loving it. And on that same possession, after the drive stalled at the 9, Indians elect to go for it on fourth down. Riley Hearn for the touchdown, cutting the lead in half. But the Red Devils would squeak by tonight, 27-26. Johnson City scored late and went for two, but was stopped at the goal line. Our Sports Extra spotlight shining on Carterville tonight as the Lions welcomed Vianna-Gorville in their final game in the Black Diamond. We started off with Jeff Aldridge on the keeper, and he's blazing out of the backfield and into the end zone for the touchdown, 7-0 Carterville. Later, on the handoff, it's Dalton James who's going to make some quick work here, getting past the Eagles defenders for the touchdown. Carterville up 14-0 at that point. The Lions continue the pounding. Zach Novak shedding defenders as he goes downfield for the score. Actually, that would set up Aldridge again, juking and jiving his way down the field for another touchdown. Carterville coast for the 41-0 win. Also in the Diamond, CCR closed out the season with a visit to Alvarado Trico. And, oh, it's a muddy night out there. And look out below. Oh, mercy. Second and 13, high snap to Alex McGill. He fumbles. Zach Ramsey recovers for the Bearcats, but their drive would stall. So scoreless into the second, CCR driving. Steven Dial airing it out to Tyler Mitchell for 28 yards. The two-point conversion made it 8-0 CCR at the half. And they go on to post the shutout 20-0. Just one other game in the Diamond tonight. Carmel White County beats El Dorado 48-20. For our final prep visual stop is DeCoin, where the Indians tuned up for their 26th straight playoff appearance with a visit from Murfreesboro. We pick it up in the third. DeCoin already up big, 42-0. Murfreesboro trying to get some offense going. Fourth and 8 for the Red Devils. Jalen McWilliams takes it all the way down to the 1. But two plays later, McWilliams, the pitch to him, he fumbles it. DeCoin is there to recover. The shutout still alive. The Indians piled up 358 yards rushing on the night. Seth Baxter, one of his two TDs here, making it 49-0. The Indians scored three TDs in a span of 54 seconds in the second quarter, and they win big, 49-0. Other regular season finales. Massac winds up 7-2 after hammering Olney 53-20. Chester beats Dupo 21-7. Bree Central over Pinckneyville 21-6. Redbud shut out Sparta 41-0. Sacred Heart Griffin out of Springfield beats Cahokia 20-6. Both those teams came into tonight 8-0. Altoff wins at Triad 12-7. Mount Carmel big over Robinson 43-14. Tomorrow, Mount Vernon hits the road to take on 6-2 Geneseo at 1 o'clock. West Frankfort also on the road. The Redbirds take on Freeburg at 1. Centralia will host Jacksonville also at 1. So here is how pairing Saturday shakes out. The IHSA will release the 256 teams that qualified for the playoffs at 6 o'clock. They'll start unveiling the brackets with 1A at 8:05, 5 minutes between classes. So we should know by 8:30 where all our local teams will be headed. Those pairings will be released at www.ihsa.org. And, of course, this program reminder. Be sure to join us next Friday night for our annual Sports Extra playoff preview. That's at 10:35 right here on TV3. Well, the football Salukis return to McAndrew Stadium tomorrow, looking to remain atop the Missouri Valley standings. The Dogs welcome Youngstown State. The Penguins are 4-2, 2-1 in the league, and coming off a bye week, Southern 4-0 in conference play. Kickoff set for 3 o'clock at the MAC. Well, that's going to do it for us. We'll be back tomorrow night with a rundown of all the playoff matchups, plus a recap of the Salukis and Penguins at Saturday Sports Extra following Texas and Mizzou. If you want to chat with us tonight, go to our website, WSILTV.com. Click on the Cover It Live link. We'll be there in just a few minutes. Have a great weekend, everyone.